Hello, hello.
Okay. Check, check.
This looks like a
One,
fun
two.
venue.
Yeah, this venue looks amazing. All right. We are here tonight in Art Battle, or in Mexico City for Art Battle. And we have 12 incredible artists here tonight who are going to be painting with us and going from blank canvas to incredible creation. My name's Morgan Booth. I'm your host for tonight, and I'm here with Gina. And Gina is our resident voting manager. Gina, how do I pronounce your last name? I was like, am I going to
Boutillier.
butcher it? Again?
Boutillier.
Okay, yes, I would have butchered it.
It's very French.
I love it. I love
I'm not, but my name is.
it. Okay, looks like we are getting the go-ahead. That sound check is good. All right, so I'm gonna throw our camera over to our venue cam, and we can start chatting about what's going on tonight. All right, just checking out the crowd. Gina, are you getting video okay?
I am.
Awesome.
Looks like we've got a great crowd.
Okay, I'm gonna turn up our venue a little bit so that we can hear our lovely announcer here. That was our intro for tonight's edition of Art Battle Mexico City. Gonna be some really amazing painters here with us tonight. Six in the first round, six in the second round, and the top two from those rounds will go into a third and final with a brand new canvas, and then one winner will emerge. You guys out there in the internets and all of these lovely people that we're seeing at the venue, will be the determining factor of which artist wins. You guys will vote. So head on over to artbattle.com/vote and support these artists. You'll be able to vote for your favorite pieces and also bid on the work to take it home. We will be beginning this round in just a few minutes.
I love this point when you're just waiting to start and you're full of anticipation as an artist.
Oh yeah, just rip-roaring to go. The artists are setting up their palettes. Oh, that tingly feeling. I know both of us have done art battle before, and so we have kind of an insight into how the artists are feeling right now.
I started as a painter. I don't know about you.
Yes, me too. We just got addicted.
We both did.
All right.
Dip a toe in and then you're hooked to the art battle.
Absolutely, absolutely. I don't know how many, I think that almost everybody that works at Art Battle has started as a painter and then just stuck around to support. All right, getting the final touches up to the easel. So lots of super strong artists tonight. I know that there's definitely a few in here that I'm really excited about. Gina, who are some of your favorites for tonight?
I'm pretty excited about Kurt, if I'm pronouncing it correctly.
Yeah, me too. Really, the colors in their work.
Right?
And we were chatting just a little bit before the show and saying that there are quite a few muralists that are going to be at the easels tonight. So it'll be interesting to see how that scale is able to translate into the smaller canvas, right?
I'm really interested to see how they translate that because we've got some huge muralists here. We're talking the full side of 10-story buildings muralists. So
yeah,
I want to see what they do on an 18 by 24.
Right? They've got the constraints of size and they've got the constraints of time.
Exactly. And I'm sure that is definitely not what they're used to.
Yeah. I think another artist that I'm super, super excited about tonight is Farid Rueda, the artist.
I am so sorry to break your heart then, because unfortunately he is not here tonight. We've had a few changes to the lineup, very last minute. So round one has been changed. So now easel one is a wild card, and there's also a wild card at easel two. In round two.
Okay. All right. Well, we're just going to have to chase Farid down for the next event, right?
Exactly.
Okay. I'm going to throw to venue here. Looks like we've got some chat going on. Looks like that was the announcement that we'll be starting super shortly. And for everyone that is out there in the internets getting excited about being here with us for Art Battle Mexico City, make sure that you head on over to artbattle.com/vote. Get registered to vote because every vote counts. Gina knows this. She's the voting manager.
It does. I usually sit around and watch the votes come in live, which is really exciting because I kind of watch the race happen.
And you've seen some really close calls too, right?
The closest we ever had was a call where the difference was 0.1 votes.
Oh man. So guys, if you think that you're like, whatever, I don't feel like clicking the link, go click the link.
Click the link because it really does matter and it helps out the artists that you want to support.
Absolutely. And all of the work is up for silent auction as well, right?
Oh yeah, and we will ship them to you. So if you are home in the internet land, wherever you may be, we can get that shipped to you safely so that you can hang it on your wall.
That's so awesome. It's such a like process, art battle, falling in love with the piece as it's being created.
I fall in love almost every art battle.
Okay, looks like our MC is making the announcements.
A la ronda final y luego a un campeonato local, nacional y campeonato mundial. Ven esta noche 12 talentos artísticos locales competirán en tres de 20 minutos. Tienen 20 minutos para mostrarnos su talento. Ok, de arte en vivo. Hoy 6 artistas en la ronda 1, otros 6 artistas en la ronda 2, y sus votos determinarán los 4 finales que irán a la ronda que determinará. Ahorita vamos a seleccionar 2 en la segunda ronda, 2 que van a la final, que son 4 participantes. Muy bien, pero vamos a comenzar, porque esa es tercera llamada, y vamos a una cuenta regresiva para animar a nuestros concursantes y a nuestros artistas. Empezamos 10,
9, 8, 7, 6, 5,
4,
3, 2, 1.
¡Comenzamos! ¡Les aplauso para los artistas! ¡Ánimo!
And we're off.
Oh.
Exciting.
First strokes are down.
Right? So exciting to hear the countdown, the famous art battle countdown in Spanish tonight. And just, it's always a thrill for me just realizing the reach of art battle across the world. And
me too.
And now with the internet, we're able to witness it from our living rooms.
Exactly. I mean, we used to be able to see the pictures as the event happened through the voting system. But now we get to have these live streams and it's so much fun.
So much fun. I can't wait to get up close to some of these works.
I'm curious to see what direction some of these artists are going to go, because I tried to get a feel for them before the event from their Instagrams and stuff, but working in Spanish is not my forte.
Yeah, we were doing some Google Translate previously, yeah, before the show. All right, and so this artist at easel number 5, is that?
That is our wild card, and I believe Admiral just sent me his name. One moment.
I'm seeing Moscouet. And from Moscouette, we're getting some really
that is
interesting, sketchy work.
Fascinating portrait beginning. It's really cool.
Yeah, just working in that that black and white, and we're literally a minute and 45 seconds in, and look at how much sketching has gone down already. And then,
right? It's already recognizable that fast.
Exactly. Like, you know that's a portrait. And then contrasting, this artist at easel 6, who I believe is Frida, we don't have anything on her canvas yet. She's still preparing her materials, maybe a little bit of tape on there.
I wonder if she's going with a stencil?
Yeah, maybe she's on the floor making a stencil right now. That'd be cool. I always love the ingenuity.
Me too, especially now with the open rules. It makes it so much more interesting because people can bring their own materials that they're more comfortable with rather than just the standard acrylic paint that we provide.
Mm-hmm. And here we are with Ariandra Obscura. And she listed her style as being Japanese 90s gothic pop. So I'm pretty stoked to see what arises from that. Somehow, Gina, I feel like that's going to fit your aesthetic. I think you're going to be into
that. I spent a little extra time on her Instagram.
I imagine.
I believe she actually also does tattoo work.
Oh, so cool. It's so interesting to see the way that these artists translate their trade across different media, from painters to muralists to tattooists. And here we've got Alejandro working in my personal fave, some gorgeous cerulean blues there.
Anyone who doesn't know, Morgan is an extremely talented painter, and she does beautiful portraits all in shades of blue. They're just stunning.
Aw, shucks. So the blue paintings in around always kind of tug at my heartstrings.
Whereas I have a soft spot for blue and pinky purple.
Ah, and here we are with Renata.
Exactly. Coming around the corner to Gina's favorite color.
Right? One of my favorite things is just going around the easels and seeing the different stages, every kind of revolution that we're going. We're only 4 minutes in right now.
And we've already got some kind of really cool little candle work going here.
Yeah, this is a really interesting, like, surreal vibes thing. Got a candle and, like, an eye on a box and lots of, like, undulating lines.
I love her style. She has a lot of that in her studio work as well.
Yeah, that kind of dark imagery and, like, smooth blended lines.
Yeah, very swirly and psychedelic. It's just gorgeous.
Mm-hmm. All right, and back with Mascouette. What do we think is going on in the chest there? Is he holding a bird?
I think he's holding a duck. Possibly a goose.
That makes me feel really nice. I would like to hold a duck also.
Me too. We're going to have a field trip.
Yes. Art Battle field trip. We're going to bring some painters along to do plein air painting while we hang out with farm animals.
I mean, I feel like this is something that we're actually doing.
Yeah. And Moskowitz's execution here is just really, really, really interesting. Like, some great gestural work with the hands. And I totally did not expect this green color coming in.
Me either. It's totally out of nowhere.
Are our friendly duck dreams being dashed right now?
Is it a snake? Are we wrong? Is the duck becoming a snake?
Right, that's the evolution of the painting. That's the risk that you run at Art Battle. All right, and here we are with Frida, and it looks like she's finally rounding into the paint application of her process, just about 7 minutes in. So she's a little bit late to the game, but I feel like she's come with a strategy.
She's got to have a plan in place. 7 minutes is a long time to prep.
Yeah, and it looks like she's going to get some clean lines, but she's going to have to rush a little bit, I think.
I do see some tape, so you will get your satisfying tape.
Oh, I love that. Give me those clean lines. All right, and here we are with Luis, and we've got some really beautiful washes going on, some nice subtlety, a lot of heavy paint application throughout the rest of the work in this round, and Luis is going a little bit more subtle.
Almost watercolor style.
Yeah.
The way he's really thinning out those washes.
And going
wondering what he's building to.
Mm-hmm. And with a smaller brush as well. So definitely, like, Luis knows what he's doing. He's more one of the more subtle artists that we have booked for tonight. He's more working in like sketches and watercolors.
Looks like we're getting some wave action going on here.
Yes, Ariana. Really great opacity from this blue and white in these waves here over top of this dark background. That's a hard one to do.
It really is. I'm impressed at how it's popping. To me, it looks like there's plans to be a figure in the waves.
Yes, I think we've got a figure emerging. I feel like it's probably going to be a female figure.
Just based on her studio work, I would agree.
Yeah. And I like this kind of building of the piece in that she's dealing with a lot of the foreground and the background first, and then she's going to go into the figure. So this is telling me that she's considered this strategy very closely.
I have a feeling she's prepped.
Oh, cool, Alejandro. This is awesome.
This is awesome.
This was a great around the easel and come back to check in on this.
It's a huge change up from the last time we were here.
And a little bit different than I think we were expecting from his studio work. His studio work is usually a bunch more abstract. We're getting very figurative, kind of mythical elements here. Really into this.
Yeah, it's stunning.
Just the texture in those. Are those wings?
I'm still trying to figure out what he's got. I can't tell if it's wings. It's definitely a woman with her arms in the air. I'm just not sure if she's throwing flowers or if it's a bird she's trying to catch.
So cool. Like, I feel like that piece is very narrative.
It definitely has a story to it.
Oh, wow. And check out Renata here.
This is really beautiful.
And all of these like undulating lines that are blending at the same time, it's almost reminding me a little bit of some Georgia O'Keeffe florals in the way that she's approaching those blends.
Absolutely. Those swirling blending colors are just, they're so soft and yet still distinct. I love this piece.
Yeah, very, this piece has a lot of presence. Oh, and she's using a smaller sketch that she's done as her reference. If you guys look up at the top of the easel.
I love bringing a reference of their own work.
Right? It's so, and yeah, I love that because you don't know whether or not the reference took 20 minutes. Also, like, just seeing the translation ability.
Yeah.
And we're just...
My rule of thumb when I was competing was always, if it was something that I was practicing, mm-hmm. I was not going over 20 minutes.
Yeah, that's, I think at one point when I was competing a lot, I was trying to practice 15-minute ones so that I could tell myself that 20 minutes would feel luxurious. That it never felt luxurious. I still, it's still
no,
20 minutes.
Never does. Oh, this is... Oh, cool.
Yeah, way more aggressive than our friendly duck hug, but
yeah,
way more interesting, I think. And checking out Moskowitz's gestural ability with these hands is really cool.
It's so graphic. I love it. His style is... I'm impressed. This was a last-minute addition to the lineup who's replacing an artist who is not able to be here tonight. And I had no idea what to expect. This is just blowing me away.
Yeah, really great job building this piece, I think. And I wonder whether or not we're going to stick with this negative space here or if we're going to get an additional color. All of these gestural
lines. I'm curious, too.
Oh, hey! I was
just sneaking a peek down at his palette there.
Hey, and we're getting our answer right away. I love when that happens.
He must have heard us.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's stunning.
Brita.
That's a tight piece.
That is so tight.
I really, really like the subtle transitions that she's using here in these waves, and we're getting that the crisp edge from, of course, the tape line that she spent so much time on.
I think this is shaping up to be absolutely incredible first round. It's going to be so hard to vote.
Yeah, it's everyone's got a tough job, but I know that there are a couple of pieces that are jumping out to me. I'm sure there are for you as well, and just people out there in the internets, every vote counts. Head on over to artbattle.com/vote and make sure that you support your favorite artist and painting from this round. The top two from this round will go on to a third and final, and will also be joined by the top two from the next round. Okay, and we're getting more into the foreground of Luis's piece, bringing that drawing down.
Still very washy, but building the washes is very pretty up in the sky.
Yeah, and it's interesting the way that this piece has been built as well, in that it's going top down. I wonder if we're
getting... Yeah, it is interesting. Instead of, you know, often it's background to foreground or foreground to background, top down is not typically what I see when I'm watching Art Battle.
Yeah, it's almost like this piece is loading from the top.
Yeah. He's a printer.
I feel like I'm dating myself.
Matrix printer.
I feel like I'm dating myself. Like, that's how the internet used to be. Seeing the image loading from the top.
Oh, I remember.
Okay, and now we're back with Arianna. Wow.
The hair movement.
Wow, stunning. And of course, here now we're starting to see even more of this Japanese influence. I think we're getting a little bit of the Great Wave, the famous painting, in the foreground, and now introduced with this contemporary kind of anime-based character.
It's stunning. It's almost like the wave is making up her gown.
Oh, gorgeous. Such great movement.
I can't wait to see the details that she pulls into that face.
Yeah, we're just seeing her working so subtly right now. Final 5 minutes. And often you don't see an artist working, waiting till the last 5 minutes to execute the face. But yeah, she's just carefully planned out minute by minute where she was going with this.
I like that she did that. It showed restraint too, because she clearly has a plan and she's not panicked or feeling rushed.
Yeah, exactly. And it's really engaging for the audience to see something being built in individual elements, I think.
Oh, absolutely. There's the element of surprise because the audience is circling as well.
Mm-hmm.
So every time they come around, there's a new element to see on each painting.
So good. All right, and we're back here with Alejandro.
Let's see if we can... Oh.
Is he holding a phoenix?
I think possibly.
Do I just want all of the figures in this round to be holding birds?
If you do, it's contagious because I'm right there with you.
But I do, I feel like that's what's happening. I feel like it's a phoenix kind of starting to wrap itself around the moon with this dark angel. Wow, this is one of the most narrative pieces that I've seen in a long time.
It tells a whole story, and it's just, this could be a book cover.
Yes, absolutely. And really, really great job establishing the movement of this piece and the way that the eye moves around the painting. We've got a lot of the weight of the painting at the bottom with this darkness and then kind of curling over into the lightness of the moon. And this piece with Renata just keeps getting cooler and cooler.
It's so cool. Oh, is that some wording on the side there?
I think so.
I can't quite read it, but it worked very well with her swirly style.
If you're out there and you're watching this, we would love to hear what you think it says.
Yeah.
And further to that, we'd love to hear what your favorite painting is. Let's chat about it. Less than 2 minutes.
I still can't pick a favorite. I think I'm going to have to abstain from voting.
I think that you can get away with that just because you're on the team. Oh, wow. And so I was really worried about the background color obscuring too much of that really wonderful gestural drawing kind of painterly stuff that we had going on in the beginning of the figure. But I think that he's done a good job here.
Yeah, I think so, too. It still pops right out.
Definitely not a duck.
No, I think we were way off base with the duck.
Oh, stunning.
Oh, my.
I would say this is the most refined piece of the bunch.
Absolutely. This may be the most refined seascape I've ever seen at NARP.
It's beautiful. And also a really interesting compositional approach, too, because she's painted a landscape in a portrait orientation, and I think that just makes it so much more interesting.
And yet she's painted it in a landscape by leaving the negative space as well, so it's almost just fascinating points here.
Yeah, it gives it that breathing space, and it makes it, I think, a little bit more contemporary.
I really love this piece. There's your tape ball.
Nice. All right. And the countdown is finished. Oh. This round is over.
Brushes down.
Oh, I love seeing all of the artists clapping too at the end.
That's my favorite part. And it's half relief and half joy.
Absolutely.
A lot of wanting to support everybody else and then just dying to see what they created. Because you're so focused in on your own painting for that 20 minutes, that getting to take that first walk around and see what everybody else was doing is really fun.
Yeah. Just like you're taking a step back from your own piece and then you're like, okay. All right. I got to go see everybody else's. Oh, wow. Looks like we're going for a very quick reset. As well.
Yeah.
All right. Voting is open. Head on over to artbattle.com/vote. The top two artists from this round will make it into the third and final round where they will compete to be the winner of the night. We will be back in just a few minutes as we get ready for round number two and a whole new bevy of six more incredible artists for you guys to see.
Thank you.
And that is the beginning of round number two for Art Battle Mexico City. My name is Morgan Booth. I'm your host commentator for tonight, and I'm here with Gina Botelli. We practiced earlier. I didn't quite get it, but we're back with a second round of six artists. These guys have 20 minutes to go from blank canvas to finish piece right in front of your eyes. You guys get to vote at artbattle.com/vote to determine the winning artist from this round. So yeah, quite the bevy of artists here tonight. Six new artists.
I'm pretty excited about some of these too.
Me too. Lots of standouts here.
Easel number two is a wild card, but she's got a name that I'm trying to read there.
I think it's Malinalli.
Malinalli. Freya. Okay.
But as we learned a minute ago, we don't trust Morgan with pronunciation, so. Oh wow, loving
that's
I'm
okay.
Digging this already. I feel like I know where this is gonna go, and I'm loving these really aggressive brush strokes
and aggressive coverage so quickly. Mm-hmm. And so dark.
Yeah, minute 45, got a third of the canvas dealt with already. Good job. Okay, and we are here with E-Flow, and I'm really excited about E-Flow, one of the artists that I've had my eye on, checking out their studio work before the show.
Really well-established figure going in already.
Yeah, check that jawline.
Right?
That's not an easy task. I think a lot of the time, people who are not used to doing portraits really underestimate just how difficult it can be to get the proportions correct. And in just under 3 minutes, we've already got a really well-proportioned portrait from E-Flow.
And then we've got a very surreal portrait happening right over here.
Yeah, we've got a third eye with Sophia. And again, very very quickly established piece already, in that the sketch has been done, and now she's cutting in what could be a hair color or a background color.
It's hard to predict.
But super, super fast. Great job on that sketch.
I'm loving this round. We've already got... Every artist we've seen has started off bold and confident.
Yes. Such a great point. Yeah, there's not a lot of, like, timid artists that we've seen so far.
No, everybody came with a plan and with their best game face. They know you've got 20 minutes to paint the best painting of your life, and then you might get to do it again.
So good. Oh, and so this artist, interesting choice. Working on the floor in this way, and You know, I love to see a reference. I hope that this stance for this artist doesn't provide any disadvantage in terms of being able to be seen by the people in the room.
I was going to say for the lighting, too.
Mm-hmm.
She's catching a lot of shadows from people walking.
I wonder, I don't think that this is an easel necessity, because there was no issue with this easel before, but we're just seeing what the artist is comfortable with. It's sometimes some quirks from the studio make their way to the art battle easel.
And it makes sense if you only paint sitting down.
Yeah.
Or if you normally paint with your canvas on the floor, mm-hmm. that's how you're comfortable. And we don't want to put you in a position that you're not going to do your best work.
Yes. Okay. And here we are with Terts. And I know that you were really excited about his work.
Very. It's very up my alley. I'm a dark, kind of creepy art girl. So Terts usually pulls out something that I love to see.
And very color palette after my own heart as well, with the red and the blue. and this is one of the artists who is coming from a muralist background, or that's usually the execution that he's doing. And so we're seeing the scale being
a lot of street art in his work, too.
Mm-hmm.
And a real street art vibe.
I'm really interested to see how that emerges. Okay, and here we are with Felipe. So Felipe is a tattoo artist primarily, and on his Instagram page, he had hashtag black and white forever. So I think that we're seeing some of that in this piece here, in this monochrome execution, and then just a little pop of color in the middle.
I really like the mix of some lettering too. We don't see it very often, and it doesn't always work, but when it works, it really works.
Yes, I agree. And we're seeing him doing a little subtle blends with his gloved finger there. And I think that that's a really great technique of not really having to worry about dirtying your hands too much, and also being able to use your fingers as tools. It's almost like a light emanating.
I'm curious to see what that's going to become. Is it a light only? Is it kind of an eyeball of light? It's very interesting the way it's coming together. And now we've got some really interesting surreal pieces tonight.
Yeah. And I'm here for it, you know? I think that in Art Battle, it can be very easy to play to the crowd and just do portraits of beautiful people.
Florals, yeah, landscape.
I think we're getting some challenging work here tonight, and I'm here for it.
I love when artists are really, you know, some artists, they want to paint florals and that's who they are. But when an artist brings their true self to Art Battle, whatever their best work is, I love to see that rather than them trying to angle, perhaps do something more crowd pleasing than what they really naturally gravitate to.
Yeah, absolutely. And interesting execution on this portrait here. I really like the way that the hair is flowing out and the sparsity of the brushstrokes towards the hairline to kind of create that texture.
Oh, wow. Speaking of defined jaw.
Yeah. This figure is very beautiful. And this earring is providing such an interesting graphic element as well.
It suddenly has this, like, 1983 Vogue cover vibe for me, yes. And I am just obsessed with it.
Yeah, it's like 80s, but make it dark.
Right? Yes.
Yeah, I'm loving this, and just the way that he's used negative space to establish that eye, just those two little triangles of white are just so beautiful and really communicating the shape in a great way.
He really did that perfectly.
And we've almost got like a peach tone in the hair.
In the hair.
I'm really enjoying I'm finding this palette to be a little bit unsettling, but I really like that.
Right? Because there's something so unnatural about it. I love it. I'm not sure what he's mixed with his blue to get precisely this just slightly off-kilter shade.
Mm-hmm. Off-kilter, yes. That's such a great, great descriptor.
Oh.
Surprise!
Hello! Hello, Red!
Oh, wow, and are these florals? I think it is, and look how quickly these florals are being communicated just by a few simple strokes.
He is so talented.
Yes, E-Flo.
Oh.
Okay, I'm back with Sophia and doing some really cool stuff, connecting these like lines of tears in this surrealist portrait.
Into and out of the hair at the top. Oh my goodness.
And really taking advantage of the negative space of the canvas. I don't think that we're going to see her covering that up. I think that this is
I really hope we don't. Illustrative. I love the way she's working with that. Mm-hmm. And just the palette that she's brought into the face, because it was just black and white the last time we were here.
Yeah. With the blue coming in. And one of my favorite moments of any portrait is the tightening up of the eye and putting in that pupil, because it just really, you get more of a sense of humanity as soon as that dark contrast is put in there. And it just really adds so much.
They really come to life at that point.
Exactly. I also really like these small highlights.
In the hair.
Yeah, just very, very subtle. Just have been kind of touched in there. They're not too demanding.
But they're there, and they establish the wave of her hair. And it's just, it's a beautiful little element, and it's so well done.
Yeah, very thoughtful. Okay, and here we are back with, is this Patricia? I believe this is Patricia.
It is Patricia, yes.
And I'm really seeing her studio work kind of coming through in this portrait.
It's subtle and so beautiful.
Yeah, and in her studio work, she was working with a lot of kind of fairly intimate portraits. Not intimate in terms of like revealing quality, but intimate in terms of private moments that maybe were a little bit melancholy, and I think we're getting that here as well.
I think you're right. I do see that coming through very well. She communicates more than just the image. It's the emotion behind it.
Yes, exactly. And I also really enjoyed what I just saw, too. I saw her using her brush to measure the proportions of the face.
Yeah. I caught that, too.
Oh, pro tips. So good.
Right? You can learn so much watching other artists paint. Little things that you don't know or you haven't been taught yourself if you've been taking art classes.
Mm-hmm.
That you really, years of practice teach you so much more. And yeah, being able to see all these different artists practice their methods is really fascinating.
Yeah, and 12 different examples of it. Like, this is a crash course. And here we are back with Terts, and gotta say, really enjoying the way that he is refining this figure.
Yeah.
especially with the blue in the eyes in place of the
white. I was going to say, the subtle blue eyes really pop for me. They almost glow, and I love when you can pull that off with paint.
Mm-hmm. And that little pop of the nose highlight as well.
Yeah.
Something that I love about his work is that he uses super, super bold colors, but is great at creating harmonizing elements between them. So some of this brown that we're seeing in the face is really bringing that blue and that red into harmony.
It's a tough thing to manage, too, when you want to work in such contrasting colors. Mm-hmm. To have them blend together seamlessly.
Oh, look at these highlights being thrown in.
Oh. How are we on time?
We have 5 minutes remaining. So for everyone who is just as wrapped up in these works as we are, and you want to support your favorite piece that you've seen, head on over to artbattle.com/vote, and you'll be able to vote for which artists from this round move forward. Yeah, this is
unexpected.
Look at
the face in the glow.
Very cool. Such soft, subtle transitions in this kind of glow shading, and then really bringing it into a contrasting illustrative quality with this black line work.
It's so strong and so bold. And again, another hugely narrative piece.
And I enjoy that the text element of this piece is also quite considered. Like, this is a font. This hasn't just been thrown on here.
No, he clearly developed his own font idea for this, mm-hmm. and executed it perfectly.
And I believe that this piece is really communicating a lot about mental health as well, which we always appreciate.
It's a huge topic, especially nowadays with COVID and having to stay home. Hasn't been easy for a lot of us.
Absolutely. Yeah, and just really, it's so great seeing all of the different ideas emerging
and
from
each
individual
them.
Artist. Yeah, how they communicate.
Yeah.
I love what I like about this piece is the subtle continuation of the bridge of the nose. I think that it's really bringing it into more of a 3D effect.
She has pulled that off so well. It's very disconcerting.
Yeah, she's coming for us. This figure is coming for us. She's going to haunt us.
Oh, yeah. I don't want to meet her on the stairs in the dark.
I don't want to meet her on the stairs.
I like the continuation of the blush up the side as well.
Yes, just kind of harmonizing the face. And those white streak elements are almost reminding me of, like, spider legs, kind of.
Yeah. You really called the florals. Those are amazing.
Yeah, just such a stunning job establishing those. And something that this artist, that Eflo, talks about as well is blending realism with abstracted elements, and I think that we're seeing that here as well with all of these soft blends in the face, but then really painterly application and gestural florals.
And that earring with the shine has almost an element of realism to it that is an interesting kind of dichotomy with the rest of the piece. So shiny.
Yeah.
That highlight.
And almost a little bit of an androgynous quality in the structure of the face, which I think just makes this portrait so much more interesting as well. Okay, Sophia. So we're seeing that she branched out into this negative space, but still is using the white to her advantage.
Yeah, she's still doing it very sparingly, very thought out. I love this.
Yeah, the tears have created like this decorative web.
And the delicate little florals. That's a great way to pop the rest of the painting with the colors that she's brought in.
Yeah, they're just playing across and bringing everything together. All right, and we're getting the signage happening. The last final few seconds.
This is going to be almost a sleeper piece because she's been on the floor. She may not be as noticed throughout the event with people walking around, but that is absolutely stunning the way she's built that face coming out of the canvas with the negative space.
Yeah, beautiful. Just really emerging. All right, and that's 20 minutes. That was a quick round.
Yeah.
I feel like that flew by. What do you guys out there in the internets think? Which is your favorite piece from this round? We'd love to hear it in the comments. And make sure that you head on over to artbattle.com/vote. And the top two artists from this round will move on. So make sure that you rep your favorites. And we will be back in just a few minutes as our people at the venue get reset for the third round, as the artists are decided, as you guys vote and bid. And we will be replaying this round for just a few minutes, and then we'll be right back to see who made it to the final. Finished piece right in front of your eyes. You guys get to vote at artbattle.com/vote to determine the winning artist from this round. So yeah, quite the bevy of artists here tonight. Six new artists.
I'm pretty excited about some of these too.
Me too. Lots of standouts here.
Easel number two is a wild card, but she's got a name that I'm trying to read there.
I think it's Malinalli.
Malinalli. Freya. Okay.
But as we learned a minute ago, we don't trust Morgan with pronunciation, so. Oh, wow. Loving.
That's okay.
I'm digging this already. I feel like I know where this is going to go, and I'm loving these really aggressive brushstrokes.
An aggressive coverage so quickly, mm-hmm. And so dark.
Yeah, minute 45, got a third of the canvas dealt with already. Good job. Okay, and we are here with E-Flow, and I'm really excited about E-Flow, one of the artists that I've had my eye on, checking out their studio work before the show.
Really well-established figure going in already.
Yeah, check that jawline.
Right?
That's not an easy task. I think a lot of the time, people who are not used to doing portraits really underestimate just how difficult it can be to get the proportions correct. And in just under 3 minutes, we've already got a really well-proportioned portrait from E-Flow.
And then we've got a very surreal portrait happening right over here.
Yeah, we've got a third eye with Sophia. And again, very quickly established piece already in that the sketch has been done. And now she's cutting in what could be a hair color or a background color.
It's hard to predict.
But super, super fast. Great job on that sketch.
I am loving this round. We've already got every artist we've seen has started off bold and confident.
Yes. Such a great point. Yeah, there's not a lot of like timid artists that we've seen so far.
No, everybody came with a plan and with their best game face. They know you've got 20 minutes to paint the best painting of your life, and then you might get to do it again.
So good. Oh, and so this artist, interesting choice, working on the floor in this way. And, you know, I love to see a reference. I hope that this stance for this artist doesn't provide any disadvantage in terms of being able to be seen by the people in the room.
I was going to say for the lighting, too.
Mm-hmm.
She's catching a lot of shadows from people walking.
I wonder, I don't think that this is an easel necessity, because there was no issue with this easel before, but we're just seeing what the artist is comfortable with. It's sometimes some quirks from the studio make their way to the art battle easel.
And it makes sense if you only paint sitting down.
Yeah.
Or if you normally paint with your canvas on the floor,
mm-hmm.
That's how you're comfortable. And we don't want to put you in a position that you're not going to do your best work.
Yes. Okay. And here we are with Terts. And I know that you were really excited about his work.
Very. It's very up my alley. I'm a dark, kind of creepy art girl. So Terts usually pulls out something that I love to see.
And very a color palette after my own heart as well, with the red and the blue. and this is one of the artists who is coming from a muralist background, or that's usually the execution that he's doing. And so we're seeing the scale being
a lot of street art in his work, too.
Mm-hmm.
And a real street art vibe.
I'm really interested to see how that emerges. Okay, and here we are with Felipe. So Felipe is a tattoo artist primarily, and on his Instagram page, he had hashtag black and white forever. So I think that we're seeing some of that in this piece here, in this monochrome execution, and then just a little pop of color in the middle.
I really like the mix of some lettering too. We don't see it very often, and it doesn't always work, but when it works, it really works.
Yes, I agree. And we're seeing him doing a little subtle blends with his gloved finger there. And I think that that's a really great technique of not really having to worry about dirtying your hands too much, and also being able to use your fingers as tools. It's almost like a light emanating.
I'm curious to see what that's going to become. Is it a light only? Is it kind of an eyeball of light? It's very interesting the way it's coming together. And now we've got some really interesting surreal pieces tonight.
Yeah. And I'm here for it, you know? I think that in Art Battle, it can be very easy to play to the crowd and just do portraits of beautiful people
Beautiful florals, landscape.
I think we're getting some challenging work here tonight, and I'm here for it.
I love when artists are really, you know, some artists, they want to paint florals and that's who they are. But when an artist brings their true self to Art Battle, whatever their best work is, I love to see that rather than them trying to angle, perhaps do something more crowd pleasing than what they really naturally gravitate to.
Yeah, absolutely. And interesting execution on this portrait here. I really like the way that the hair is flowing out and the sparsity of the brushstrokes towards the hairline to kind of create that texture.
Oh, wow. Speaking of defined jaw.
Yeah. This figure is very beautiful, and this earring is providing such an interesting graphic element as well.
It suddenly has this like 1983 Vogue cover vibe for me. Yes. And I am just obsessed with it.
Yeah, it's like 80s but make it dark,
right?
Yeah, I'm loving this. And just the way that he's used negative space to establish that eye, just those two little triangles of white are just so beautiful and really communicating the shape in a great way.
He really did that perfectly.
And we've almost got like a peach tone in the hair.
In the hair.
I'm really enjoying I'm finding this palette to be a little bit unsettling. But I really like that.
Right? Because there's something so unnatural about it. I love it. I'm not sure what he's mixed with his blue to get precisely this just slightly off-kilter shade.
Mm-hmm. Off-kilter, yes. That's such a great descriptor.
Oh.
Surprise!
Hello, Red.
Oh, wow. And are these florals? I think it is. And look how quickly these florals are being communicated just by a few simple strokes.
He is so talented.
Yes, Eflo.
Oh.
Okay, I'm back with Sophia. And doing some really cool stuff. Connecting these like lines of tears in this surrealist portrait
into and out of the hair at the top. Oh my goodness.
And really taking advantage of the negative space of the canvas. I don't think that we're gonna see her covering that up. I think that this is
I really hope we don't illustrative. I love the way she's working with that. Mm-hmm. And just the palette that she's brought into the face, because it was just black and white the last time we were here.
Yeah. And one of my favorite moments of any portrait is the tightening up of the eye and putting in that pupil, because it just really, you get more of a sense of humanity as soon as that dark contrast is put in there. And it just really adds so much.
They really come to life at that point.
Exactly. I also really like these small highlights.
In the hair.
Yeah, just very, very subtle. Just have been kind of touched in there. They're not too demanding.
But they're there and they establish the wave of her hair. And it's just, it's a beautiful little element and it's so well done.
Yeah, very thoughtful. Okay, and here we are back with, is this Patricia? I believe this is Patricia.
It is Patricia, yes.
And I'm really seeing her studio work kind of coming through in this portrait.
It's subtle and so beautiful.
Yeah, and in her studio work, she was working with a lot of kind of fairly intimate portraits. Not intimate in terms of like revealing quality, but intimate in terms of private moments that maybe were a little bit melancholy, and I think we're getting that here as well.
I think you're right. I do see that coming through very well. She communicates more than just the image. It's the emotion behind it.
Yes, exactly. And I also really enjoyed what I just saw, too. I saw her using her brush to measure the proportions of the face.
Yeah. I caught that, too.
Oh, pro tips. So good.
Right? You can learn so much watching other artists paint. Little things that you don't know or you haven't been taught yourself if you've been taking art classes.
Mm-hmm.
That you really, years of practice teach you so much more. And being able to see all these different artists practice their methods is really fascinating.
Yeah, and 12 different examples of it. Like, this is a crash course. And here we are back with Terts, and gotta say, really enjoying the way that he is refining this figure.
Yeah.
Especially with the blue in the eyes in place of the
white. I was gonna say, the subtle blue eyes really pop for me. They almost glow, and I love when you can pull that off with paint.
Mm-hmm. And that little pop of the nose highlight as well.
Yeah.
Something that I love about his work is that he uses super, super bold colors, but is great at creating harmonizing elements between them. So some of this brown that we're seeing in the face is really bringing that blue and that red into harmony.
It's a tough thing to manage, too, when you want to work in such contrasting colors.
Mm-hmm.
To have them blend together seamlessly.
Oh, look at these highlights being thrown in.
Oh. How are we on time?
We have 5 minutes remaining. So for everyone who is just as wrapped up in these works as we are, and you want to support your favorite piece that you've seen, head on over to artbattle.com/vote, and you'll be able to vote for which artist from this round move forward. Yeah, this is unexpected.
Look at the face in the glow.
Very cool. Such soft, subtle transitions in this kind of glow shading, and then really bringing it into a contrasting illustrative quality with this black line work.
It's so strong and so bold. And again, another hugely narrative piece.
And I enjoy that the text element of this piece is also quite considered. Like, this is a font. This hasn't just been thrown on here.
No, he clearly developed his own font idea for this,
mm-hmm.
and executed it perfectly.
And I believe that this piece is really communicating a lot about mental health as well, which we always appreciate.
It's a huge topic, especially nowadays with COVID and having to stay home. Hasn't been easy for a lot of us.
Absolutely. Yeah, and just really, it's so great seeing all of the different ideas emerging
and
from
how to
each
communicate
individual
them.
Artist. Yeah, how they communicate.
Yeah.
I love, what I like about this piece is the subtle continuation of the bridge of the nose. I think that it's really bringing it into more of a 3D effect.
She has pulled that off so well, it's very disconcerting.
Yeah, she's coming for us. This figure is coming for us. She's going to haunt us.
Oh, tonight. Yeah. I don't want to meet her on the stairs in the dark.
I don't want to meet her on the stairs.
I like the continuation of the blush up the side as well.
Yes, just kind of harmonizing the face. And those white streak elements are almost reminding me of, like, spider legs, kind of.
Yeah. You really called the florals. Those are amazing.
Yeah, just such a stunning job establishing those. And something that this artist, that Eflo, talks about as well is blending realism with abstracted elements. And I think that we're seeing that here as well with all of these soft blends in the face, but then really painterly application and gestural florals.
And that earring with the shine has almost an element of realism to it that is an interesting kind of dichotomy with the rest of the piece. It's so shiny.
Yeah.
With that highlight.
And almost a little bit of an androgynous quality in the structure of the face, which I think just makes this portrait so much more interesting as well. Okay, Sophia, so we're seeing that she branched out into this negative space, but still is using the white to her advantage.
Yeah, she's still doing it very sparingly. It's very thought out. I love this.
Yeah, the tears have created like this decorative web.
And the delicate little florals. That's a great way to pop the rest of the painting with the colors that she's brought in.
Yeah, they're just playing across and bringing everything together. All right, and we're getting the signage happening. The last final few seconds.
This is going to be almost a sleeper piece because she's been on the floor. She may not be as noticed throughout the event with people walking around, but that is absolutely stunning the way she's built that face coming out of the canvas with the neck.
Solo hay tres. Salud,
¿tú hablas inglés?
Yes. ¿Qué quieres hacer?
¿Qué está pasando, chica?
Right, and we are back for round number 3 of Art Battle Mexico City. My name is Morgan Booth. I'm your commentator for tonight, and I am here with Gina Beautillier, our
hey,
resident,
you got it.
Yeah, right? Our resident artist expert and voting manager extraordinaire. So we're here for the third round, and the artists who have made it through at easel number 1, Terts, at easel number 2, Renata Molinera Camargo, at easel number 3, E-Flow, and at easel number 4, Mascouette. So,
very exciting final four.
The cream of the crop here. And, oh, I love, Renata came confident. She brought a second piece here. A second little study.
She did the purple swirly piece in the first round.
Yeah. And we've got E-Flow here, who did that incredible blue portrait with that floral crown. And it looks like we're getting a similar approach here with those dark eyes. It's very similar to how he did started his first round piece.
He establishes his figure very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if we're going to get the same nice, subtle Day of the Dead detailing in the face.
I think that we are. E-Flow, it's prominent in his studio work. And I think he's bringing it with him to the 20 minutes.
Ooh, Terts is off to a heavy, bold start here.
Yeah, look at these, the like confidence of these strokes. Two minutes in, and is this, I'm getting possible skull?
I feel skull. It's incredible the way this early on, there's already some shading effect going on to the point that it feels a little bit rounded.
Yeah, and a less saturated palette than we saw last round, but I'm sure it'll be no less of an impressive piece.
Still bold colors, just more muted.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just sculpting these kind of cheekbone areas right now. Okay, and now we're coming back over to Mascouette.
Another strong portrait stack.
Yeah, and a little bit of a surprise with that green skin tone, but I'm here for it.
Hey, why not?
And looks like we're getting something that's fairly topical with a portrait that has a mask as well.
I wonder if he's got his eye on someone in the audience to use as a reference.
Oh, that's always such a good trick. And then when the audience figures that out, they're like, they feel like they're in on it.
Right. And if you're going to do a portrait, why not? You've got plenty of great references circling around you.
Yeah. You're like, hey, you, hold still.
Yeah. Can you stand here for a minute?
I've literally seen that.
Oh, me too.
some tricksy artists. Oh, that was a nice cheek highlight there.
It always amazes me how fast they have everything established.
Yeah, like, I think that a lot of people believe that the last few minutes would be the most important, but I would argue that it's the first five.
Me too.
Because that's your laying out your whole structure. And once you go, once you've established that, there's really no going back.
No, and if at 5 minutes you've realize that your proportions are off, it's really difficult to fix.
Yeah, and especially being in the time constraint and having the audience basically at your back, you don't have the opportunity to step back from the painting to assess in the same way that you would in the studio.
And you're also working wet on wet on wet.
Yeah, wet wet.
Oh yeah. Heavy, thick, wet paint.
Yeah, and oh man, Renata's, I feel like she's going to give us another really interesting, surreal composition that just keeps us guessing.
I absolutely love her vibe with just a subtle swirling shading.
So good. And checking out her studio work earlier, I was noticing that there was a lot of those swirling shades, but also in other pieces, there were a lot of kind of harsh angles like we're seeing now, and it looks like she's going to be marrying those two modes. Whoa! We got a double brusher!
I love seeing a double brush.
Oh man, this is badass. This is never not badass.
We've got that peach tone again.
I wonder if we're going to see florals laid over top of that in the same way. And I think, yeah, that peach tone helps it just look more whole when the kind of sketch of the flower is laid over top of it.
It really does. It's a really good undertone.
Really enjoying the way that Eflo builds his piece and just so stoked on the performative element of that double brush.
It's always so exciting.
Oh man, and that takes so much confidence too. Because you know everyone's watching you at that point.
Sometimes you want everyone watching you.
Oh yeah.
I have a feeling Eflo has a lot of confidence. And the more performative you are, sometimes the better your votes go.
Yeah, for sure. Like everyone, you're commanding the floor. And as soon as you you have your left and your right hand going all at once, I feel like the audience just snaps over. They're like, whoa, what's that guy doing? And speaking of what's that guy doing, Terz has done such an incredible job communicating quality of light on this skull. Really getting that highlight on top there.
It pops so well. And you're right, this is a much more muted palette, more subtle colors than his first piece, and I am just loving some of the choices here.
Yeah, providing a nice contrast, so still very stylistically him in terms of brushwork, but I think giving the audience a different element of his work with changing up the palette.
Absolutely. And I think keeping it a little more subtle and less of one of his characters and more one of his subject paintings.
Yes, such a good point. Yeah, less exaggerated than I think we're used to seeing from him in some areas of his studio work. And very
the
focused.
The depth is stunning.
Yeah, very focused on rendering, creating yeah. that depth. Okay, and now we're getting this dark contrast created here against the figure from Moscouette.
Very dark and gloomy palette happening here.
Yeah, dark and gloomy, a lot of very much in the same color family. Really establishing a vibe very clearly.
I love a good monochromatic portrait.
I'll take that. I'll choose to take that personally.
You should. I love your work.
I really like the gestural quality of the shirt in the bottom of this, and I do feel like it will be fleshed out, but I'm enjoying it nonetheless. Something that I love about Art Battle is the way that an artist builds a piece from sketch to finish. You're able to see all of those in-between stages and the different energy that they have.
I love the in-between stages.
Oh, and I like that we just saw someone scoop their hand in there and just got a really, really up-close portrait. Like, as he was rinsing his brush and turned over to the side, that phone was, like, 2 inches away from the canvas.
You gotta take pictures. That's all I do if I'm there in person. Circle, picture.
All right, Renata. I feel like she was serving us Georgia O'Keeffe in the first round, and now I'm getting some distinctly Francis Bacon. Like, I'm here for it.
I love her.
So much energy.
Whole deal.
Wow, so much energy in this piece, and such unique energy. And sometimes the artists that we work with that do more off the beaten path or more unique pieces aren't necessarily fan favorites. So I'm really excited that Renata has challenged us with both of her pieces and that the audience is responding in support. Love seeing that.
Me too. It's really nice to see not just more traditional pieces being favored.
Just this like undulating establishment of these shadows. She's got her sharp lines in the foreground of this kind of sculptural stack of abstracted faces.
I love her abstracted faces with the third eye. The whole pile.
So cool.
And it's very reminiscent of some of her studio pieces.
Absolutely. Oh man, check the throat highlight on Eflo's portrait.
It's so smooth.
So nice. Really, really considered placement of highlights here, showing that Eflo has a really good idea of the way that light hits a face. And again,
he has an incredibly good painterly eye.
Yes. And again, we're getting hit with these gorgeous gestural flowers.
Which may look simple, but they're incredibly difficult.
Right? And like, he literally just like throws those in with the slashes. And we know
it's that unreal.
He's able to do that and make it look like flowers because he's practiced. So people forget.
Oh, that is years and years of practice.
Yeah, like people forget that Art Battle isn't just 20 minutes. It's also however many years you've spent creating work.
Exactly, and establishing your style. Which takes a long time.
Yeah. Loving these highlight placements from Turtz over here. Really,
this is such a subtle, beautiful piece.
Yeah, and again, we're getting that the two very different color families being blended in a really harmonious way.
Which is so incredibly difficult to do, and he's clearly practiced this to such a degree that it's just second nature.
Yeah, like it doesn't look muddy at all. Like how?
No, which is so difficult wet on wet like this.
Yeah, difficult wet on wet, and difficult working with literally the opposite ends of the color wheel. And you're not making mud? Like, Turts, please teach. Would like.
Yeah, I need to know what magic you're using here, because this is, I think, incredibly skilled.
Yeah, is he mixing on the canvas, or is he mixed a mid-tone in his palette?
We need a shot of his palette.
Yeah.
The nosy artists. Teach me!
Right? Give up all your pro tips, all your secrets.
Oh, so cool.
Yeah,
these little skull elements being added into this.
Yeah, didn't expect that.
I love the surprises tonight. It just keep being thrown our way.
And I love that these skulls are in this negative space as well. They just like exist as like kind of cascading.
This is such a moody piece. And it might be my favorite of the whole night.
It's so cool. And we've got this kind of like Victorian collar going on.
Just, I'm obsessed with the detail to this.
Yeah, really, really thoughtful execution here. But really quick, confident strokes as well.
I haven't seen a reference from him all night, so he is just pulling this out of his head, and I love that.
Oh, I admire that so much.
Me too. I'm a reference girl. I definitely prefer working from a reference.
Yes, absolutely. Reference is my cozy place.
It's my crutch.
And are we getting some writing elements up in the top corner there as well? I think maybe it says 2021.
I think it might.
Oh, I'm glad that we caught that stroke from Renetta.
Such a... the color she's pulling without, again, making mud. All these artists tonight are really clean with their colors.
Yes, absolutely. Just really, really honoring the vibrancy of the paint. Ooh, I can see what Eflo's up to in the background, and I'm stoked. 4 minutes only remaining. If you guys are out there and you want to support your favorite artist from this round, make sure that you head on over to artbattle.com/vote. Every vote does count. These works are also up for silent auction. So if you're falling in love in the same way I think that Gina and I are throughout this round, you can purchase one of these pieces and we'll send it to you. We will ship it. Wow.
I have a feeling I might be shipping some to myself.
Such great texture.
It's incredible that she's getting that yellow to look bright and yellow without getting any muddiness to it.
Yeah, just really, really thoughtful application here, and she's just honing in those faces now. Ooh, in the final 3 minutes.
Make sure the eyes pop.
I feel like this is a piece that you could just keep staring at and staring at and staring at.
Oh, forever. There's always a new little line of color that you haven't noticed before.
Mm-hmm. Ugh. Check the atmosphere feather from Eflow. Oh my goodness. These beautiful patterned marks.
It's almost like feathers.
Yes. I'm so excited that all of this beautiful brushwork and movement that we're seeing in the figure is now surrounding it in this halo.
it really fills up that negative space in the blue so well, because before it was just this flat blue, and now we've got so much motion going on.
Yeah, it's taken it from being a more graphic in terms of like just communication piece, and has really made it just expand so much more and created more of a holistic piece. And Tert's here, just punching in his final little
shine. And
yeah, final little shines, just so thoughtfully placed.
A little pop of shine on the forehead is absolutely perfect.
And I like this composition too, as well, that it's just cheated a little bit above center. I feel like it's a really nice balance.
All the artists in it have pulled off some just lovely composition, which is, again, not an easy thing to do.
Yeah. Ugh. Oh, this is making me itch to get back to the easel. And if you guys out there are wanting to try your hand at Art Battle as well, we're always looking for artists. Head on over to artbattle.com and fill out an artist application. Ooh, final 30 seconds remaining.
Oh. Final brush strokes. Oh, I'm glad we're getting another view of this.
Yeah, Moscouette. Wow.
I love the very subtle green color to it, though.
Yeah. So good at establishing a mood. All right, and that is the end of the third and final round for Art Battle Mexico City. One winner will emerge. Very, very
exciting. What an incredible 16 paintings tonight.
Yeah. Like, oh, who? It's going to be tough to choose the winner from this final four. Really, really strong final round, but also just really impressed and honored with the amount of awesome art tonight.
This was an exceptional night for art.
Absolutely. And thank you, everyone, for joining us. But your job is not done yet. You gotta help us choose the winner.
I'm watching people vote. I want more people to vote.
Let me pull up our voting link up here so that everyone can see. Artbattle.com/vote. Choose your favorite artist. And we will be back in just a few minutes as the votes roll in. Thanks for being with us. emerging. All right, and that's 20 minutes. That was a quick round.
Yeah.
I feel like that flew by. What do you guys out there in the internet think? Finished piece right in front of your eyes. You guys get to vote at artbattle.com/vote to determine the winning artist from this round. So, yeah, quite the bevy of artists here tonight. 6 new artists.
I'm pretty excited about some of these, too.
Me, too. Lots of standouts here.
Easel number 2 is a wild card, but she's got a name that I'm trying to read there.
I think it's Malinalli?
Malinalli. Freya. Okay.
But as we learned a minute ago, we don't trust Morgan with pronunciation, so. Oh, wow. Loving.
That's okay.
I'm digging this already. I feel like I know where this is going to go. And I'm loving these really aggressive brushstrokes.
An aggressive coverage so quickly and so dark.
Yeah, minute 45, got a third of the canvas dealt with already. Good job. Okay, and we are here with E-Flow. And I'm really excited about E-Flow, one of the artists that I've had my eye on, checking out their studio work before the show.
Really well-established figure going in already.
Yeah, check that jawline.
Right?
That's not an easy task. I think a lot of the time, people who are not used to doing portraits really underestimate just how difficult it can be to get the proportions correct. And in just under 3 minutes, we've already got a really well-proportioned portrait from E-Flow.
And then we've got a very surreal portrait happening right over here.
Yeah, we've got a third eye with Sophia. And again, very very quickly established piece already in that the sketch has been done. And now she's cutting in what could be a hair color or a background color.
It's hard to predict.
But super, super fast. Great job on that sketch.
I am loving this round. We've already got every artist we've seen has started off bold and confident.
Yes. Such a great point. Yeah, there's not a lot of like timid artists that we've seen so far.
No, everybody came with a plan and with their best game face. They know. You've got 20 minutes to paint the best painting of your life, and then you might get to do it again.
So good. And so this artist, interesting choice, working on the floor in this way. And, you know, I love to see a reference. I hope that this stance for this artist doesn't provide any disadvantage in terms of being able to be seen by the people in the room.
I was going to say for the lighting too. She's catching a lot of shadows from people walking.
I don't think that this is an easel necessity, because there was no issue with this easel before, but we're just seeing what the artist is comfortable with. It's sometimes some quirks from the studio make their way to the art battle easel.
And it makes sense if you only paint sitting down.
Yeah.
Or if you normally paint with your canvas on the floor, that's how you're comfortable. And we don't want to put you in a position that you're not going to do your best work.
Yes. Okay. And here we are with Terts. And I know that you were really excited about his work.
Very. It's very up my alley. I'm a dark, kind of creepy art girl, so Hertz usually pulls out something that I love to see.
And very color palette after my own heart as well, with the red and the blue. and this is one of the artists who is coming from a muralist background, or that's usually the execution that he's doing. And so we're seeing the scale being
a lot of street art in his work too.
Mm-hmm.
And a real street art vibe.
I'm really interested to see how that emerges.
allí enfrente donde está la cámara para que nos vean en toda la Unión. Haters. De verdad, que lo ignoran a uno. Se mueven ahí a los cuatro finalistas, por favor, para que pasen en toda. Estamos pasando en vivo. Así que ya tengo a su campeón. Falta uno, ¿no? Ahí está. Muy bien. Ya tengo a su campeón de estos cuatro finalistas. Quiero agradecer a todos por acompañarnos en Art Bayern. Vamos teniendo los golpes. Pero antes, yo quisiera pedir un fuerte aplauso para todos y cada uno de los artistas que estuvieron con nosotros el día de hoy. En Estados Unidos, más de 30 ciudades. En Europa, más de 30 ciudades. En México, solo 3 ciudades. Creo que tenemos más talento y más artistas. Así que vamos a promocionar. Denle like a Art Battle. Inviten a sus amigos que sepan que tienen talento para que esto crezca en más ciudades de la Ciudad de México. Y nos vayamos a la internacional. Y que el mundo sepa que los mexicanos somos talentosos. Muchas felicidades a los cuatro finalistas. Y el campeón de esta jornada, de esta noche, que se va a la final de la Ciudad de México y después a la final nacional, si gana, ¿verdad? ¡Nuestro ganador esta noche! ¡Moscú!
Que iba a ganar.
Acá al escenario. Te voy a dar tu diploma, que es algo así significativo, porque viene lo mejor. O sea, tienes que estar en las eliminatorias de la Ciudad de México y luego en la Nacional, ¿ok? Entonces, esto es para ti. Álvaro, Ciudad de México, campeón, 5 de febrero. Saben que es de verdad una sorpresa, porque él fue el comodín de esta noche. Él fue el comodín, él no se había inscrito en el primer momento. Él ya se fue un campeón, pero él no quiere llegar. Así estaba la verdad. Pero no teníamos idea quién iba a ser el comodín. Y los tiempos de ellos son perfectos. Así que, usted no lo teníamos pensado ni duda, por favor. En la Ciudad de México. Aquí está tu premio de efectivo. Ah, no, tú sabes los no sé. Yo estoy aquí de chismosa. Yo no le quedaría el premio en efectivo. Si no lo tienes, no te preocupes, que te quedas con el diploma. Y no te
¡cerveza para todos, gratis!
El aplauso porque ni él se lo esperaba. Se sí, imagino que va a llegar a su casa.
¡No se
cubran bocas! ¡El aplauso para nuestro campeón! ¡El hombre Álvaro! Tenía uno que es el lugar que hoy nos ha abierto las puertas y que se ha apuntado maravillosamente con Álvaro en toda la organización de esto. Muchísimas gracias por abrir las puertas. A todo el staff de Art Battle, griten por favor.